Hi guys, in this video I explain recursion. I use an example to sum up the values from 1 through n. I first demonstrate an iterative solution, followed by a recursive solution. Now I'll declare a couple of prototypes. The first is called sum and expects a single argument named n. And then I have sum recursive. This also expects a single argument. Now both of these compute the sum on the values 1 through n, and n is defined by the argument that is provided. And then they return the sum as a value. Now let's start with the iterative solution. The iterative solution uses loops. So first I need a counter or a total. This one I initialize to 0, so initially there's nothing to count up. I use a simple loop. I initialize this to n, and then I count, I do it backwards. So I start at n and then count down all the way until 1. And I do minus minus, and then each value I add to the total. And then finally I return the total. So let's add an example here. Let's say n is 4. This will count on 4, 3, 2, and 1, and add all each of these that it counts down, right? It adds to the total and returns it. Now let's move on to the recursive solution. Now recursion doesn't use any loops. Instead, it uses three things. It uses a function, it uses a base case, and it uses a recursive case. The recursive case is the function call. So since it cannot use a loop, since it doesn't use a loop to repeat certain actions, it simply calls the same function again and again. And that is the recursion. Now, if we call a function inside from itself recursively, there's no end to it, right? It would continue, continue, continue. This is where the base case comes in. So the base case stops the recursion, and here we have the recursive case. The recursive case is essentially a condition. It's kind of like the condition in a loop. If we don't have a condition here, the loop would continue indefinitely. So here we have to define, when do we want to stop the recursion? And the recursive call starts with n. So this is 4. It counts down 3, 2, 1. So we still want to do process 1, but we want to stop when it reaches 0. So here I do if n is less than or equal 0, I want to stop and I return n. So this is the base value that we're returning. If we sum up the values, I could return 0. I could even update it in this case to just be less than or equal 1. If it's 1, it simply returns 1. Now this is the recursive case. This is where we stop. What if it's larger than 1? What if it is 2, 3, 4, or even higher? In this case, we want to take the value that's provided, let's say for example 4, and we want to add all the remaining values starting at 3 and counting down. And this is the recursive function call here. Recursive, sum recursive, n. Now, I don't want to do n again, because then I would call it with 4, 4, 4, 4, and over. So in this case, when I have 4, I want to calculate the recursion for n minus 1, so that I count it for 3. Then when I get 3, I do 3 plus recursion of 2, and then 1, and so on. So the n minus 1 is essentially the decrement operator, or the iteration of the loop that is defined with the update operation. This is the base case, the condition, and then this one here is the recursive case. Now the recursive case is also combined with the operation. This is my plus here. I have a small typo here, so sum recursive, and that should be it. Now I go to the main and I define a sample value. I will use 4, So int n equals 4. And then I call total1, which will be the iterative solution, passing in sum. And then I have a total2, which is the recursive solution. And then I output both. I output sum iterative solution. And I output sum with the recursive solution. Now let's run this. Now both of them give 10. So it counts 4 plus 3 is 7, plus 2 is 9, plus 1 is 10. If I update this to 5, it should give us 15. And then both are 15. So the iterative solution always uses loops. It starts a variable for the total and then uses a loop. The loop here we could also write from i0 and then counting up. It doesn't really matter. I chose the countdown solution because it is closer to the recursive solution. So by starting at n, it's closer to what the recursive solution does. The recursive solution doesn't need a loop or that never uses a loop. Instead, it uses a function that it can call recursively. So here it calls it with 4. The base case defines when to stop, so 4 we don't stop. Then it does 4 plus the function call, right? Sum recursive. And here it passes in 3. Now when we have the recursive call, sum 3, doesn't hit the base case yet. So this resolves to 3 plus sum recursive and 2. So 3 minus 1. Now sum recursive also doesn't hit the base case. So this will resolve to 2 plus sum recursive and 1. Now sum 1 doesn't hit the base case. So this one will simply return 1 here. And when 1 is returned, it goes back to the previous function call, this one here. So this one will now be 1 plus 2. So it adds these two up, this will be 3. Now the previous function call, 3 plus 3, it will add 6. And then it adds up the last function call, 4 plus 6, this would be 10. And here it gets the result, then it returns 10 to the very first function call that we made. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.